Hello everyone, this is Tarunabh, an independent filmmaker and an AI explorer. I have created this tutorial to introduce the latest open-sourced SDXL 1.0 model created by the Stability AI team. This model has been released yesterday and I have already taken it for a test run and I can't wait to share my wonderful results with you all. So what makes SDXL 1.0 so special? Firstly, it's capable of generating high-quality images in virtually any artistic style. SDXL 1.0 is specifically designed for vibrant and accurate colors with improved contrast, lighting, and shadows compared to its predecessor. Creating complex, detailed, and aesthetically pleasing images with SDXL 1.0 requires only a few words. No longer are qualifier terms such as masterpiece, highest quality, photorealistic, hyperrealistic, etc. are required to obtain high quality images. Secondly, all outputs have a native resolution of 1024 by 1024, which is double that of the predecessor Stable Diffusion 1.5 release. There are several ways to get started with SDXL 1.0. It's live on Clip Drop, Dream Studio, and a Stable Diffusion Discord community, which has been open for beta testing of the SDXL models since several weeks now. The previous model was 0.9, which I have tested myself, and I have also seen the rapid growth of the Discord community since I joined it in August 2022. The weights of SDXL 1.0 and the associated source code have been released on the Stability AI GitHub page and also on Hugging Face. In today's tutorial, I will walk you through how to update your Automatic 1111 web UI and use the new Stable Diffusion SDXL 1.0 model. Before we start, make sure you are familiar with running Stable Diffusion locally using the Automatic 1111 web UI. Although there are many tutorials available on YouTube on how to install it, if you want me to create a detailed tutorial on how to set up the Automatic 1111 web UI, then please leave your request in the comments section below. Step 1. Updating the Automatic 1111 web UI. First, we need to update the Automatic 1111 web UI. Head over to their GitHub page and download the latest zip file from the drop-down menu of the code button. Once downloaded, extract the file. Now copy all the files except for the webui-user.bat file and paste them into your installed Automatic 1111 folder, replacing all the existing files and folders. Step 2. Modifying the webuser.bat file. Next, we are going to modify the webuser.bat file using an advanced text editor like Notepad++. To ensure that SDXL runs smoothly, add the following parameters: --xformers. If you have a low-end graphics card, you may want to use the MadVRM or NoHub VAE parameters. After editing, remember to save the file. Step 3. Downloading and placing the model files. Now let's download the model files. Visit the files and versions page, links is provided in the description below, and download the base safe tensor file, the offset LoRa file, and the refiner file. Once downloaded, place these files into your model's Stable Diffusion directory. For the LoRa file, go up one directory and put the SDXL offset LoRa in the LoRa's directory. Step 4. Launching the Automatic 1111 web UI. Finally, we are ready to launch the updated Automatic 1111. Run the webuser.bat file. It might take a while to load. In the Stable Diffusion checkpoint selector, you should now be able to select the Stable Diffusion XL base 1.0 model. If you don't see it at the first run, hit the refresh button. If you find that some of your previously installed extensions are causing an issue with the SDXL model, then you should try disabling them and see if the problem has been resolved. Certain users have suggested that after disabling the extensions, the SDXL model ran smoothly. So you might want to try that option if you are facing problems. In my case, I did not face any such problem. That's why I did not disable any of my extensions. Step 5. Running the SDXL 1.0 model. Once you have selected the SDXL base model from the Stable Diffusion checkpoint drop-down menu, you must proceed to the Text to Image tab and then write your first prompt. For the purpose of this demonstration, the first text prompt that I have chosen is a simple lines hand-drawn fashion sketch, and I have also included a negative prompt, and I have selected the sampling method as Euler A. And for the image resolution, SDXL 1.0 supports a base resolution of 1024 by 1024, and anything below this might produce artifacts, but I have observed that I can go to a lower limit of 896 and an upper limit of 1536 before my graphics card 4090 RTX breaks down and produces a CUDA out of memory error. Now for the first test run, let's go with a resolution of 1024 by 1024. I have kept the sampling steps to 20 and I will hit generate. And after that, as you can see, the progress is displayed on the command window. And as you can see, the results are pretty impressive. And finally, I am done with the generation and look at these final outputs. This is really impressive for a base model which hasn't been fine-tuned. In the next step, I will try out a higher resolution, which is 1536 by 1024, and then again press on generate. And in the very first attempt, I can go up to a high resolution of 1536. Previously, I could only go up to a resolution of 768 in the first test. So this is a huge improvement. And as you can see, even for non-square ratios, the results are pretty good. Once you complete the text-to-image generations, you can proceed to the image-to-image tab and select the SDXL refiner model. This is the second step you need to complete and thereby utilize the full potential of the SDXL model. I will keep the resolution of the image as same, and for the sampling method, I will choose a new one, which is DPM++2M Keras, and hopefully this will bring out more details in the new generated output. I will keep the denoising strength low to ensure a closer resemblance with the original image, or better still, I will try out 0.4, and then keeping the checkpoint as SDXL refiner, I will again hit generate. And once it is completed, here is the new result, and I am already seeing lots of extra details. You will notice them if you look at the eyes and the hands as compared to the initial image. Let's try out another image. This time I will go for the photorealistic look. So I am again back in the text to image tab. Please keep in mind that the SDXL base model is the first step that should be used only in the text to image tab, and the SDXL refiner model should be used as a secondary step in the image to image tab. With a new prompt and keeping the rest of the configurations the same, I will hit the generate button. As you can see, the final result is looking really good. It is photorealistic, although it is not as detailed as I was expecting, especially if you look at the face of the reindeer inside the snow globes. But since this is just the first step, now I can send the final output to the image to image tab and use the SDXL refiner model to add new details to the image. I will keep the resolution same, but this time I will use a new sampling method, which is DPM++2M Keras. And then hit the generate button, and as you can see, the final result has added certain details, but even then the face is looking distorted, although slightly better than the original. Let me try enhancing another image of the same batch. I will try to enhance it using the SDXL refiner model in the image to image step, and after it has completed generating, there is definitely significant improvement in the final result as compared to the initial image. So this demonstration proves that the SDXL base model as a standalone model cannot produce the best results. It needs to be combined with the SDXL refiner model in order to produce the best possible quality results. Step 6, exploring fine-tuned models trained on SDXL 1.0. I will now try out a new fine-tuned model that has been trained on SDXL 1.0, which is the Dreamshaper XL. And this model is available for download on civitai.com, which is a database of all the customized models that has been trained and fine-tuned by the users of Stable Diffusion. I used the same prompt as I had used before. At the time of the recording of this video, Dreamshaper XL is one of the earliest example of a fine-tuned model using SDXL 1.0 as a base. And as you can see, the results of the first stage, which is text to image, are really interesting. And then moving on to the second stage, which is using the SDXL refiner model in the image to image tab, I have successfully added more details to the initial image. And since these are early days of experimentation with the SDXL base model, you must experiment with various parameters and various configurations and see which one works best for you. So I hope you liked this video and found it useful. If you have any doubts or queries, please write them in the comments below. For the record, I am not a Python or coding expert. I am just a filmmaker, mostly focusing on the creative aspect. And like most of you, I am still learning the ropes of this new technology. And I offer my sincerest apologies for any mistakes that I might have unwittingly committed while creating this tutorial. Until next time, this is Tarunabh signing off from TD Film Studio. Thank you for watching.